Mr. Mayor, Excellencies, distinguished guests, dear friends, it is my privilege and honor to welcome you to today's special ceremony. We are here to recognize the recipients of the 2022 OPCW-The Hague Award. In 2013, the OPCW was awarded, as you know, the Nobel Peace Prize in recognition of its extensive efforts to eliminate chemical weapons. To preserve the legacy of this achievement, the OPCW established the OPCW-The Hague Award in collaboration with the Municipality of The Hague in 2014. The OPCW-The Hague Award recognizes individuals and organizations that play a significant role in advancing the goals of the Chemical Weapons Convention. To date, this accolade has been bestowed on 9 recipients from different geographical regions and areas, including academia, science, chemical industry, international and regional organizations, and civil society. From the beginning of this award program, the Municipality of The Hague, the city of peace and justice, has shared the ideals of the organization and the goals of the Hague Award. In this solemn occasion, I express my sincere appreciation to the Municipality of The Hague for its strong and lasting support to the OPCW. I will have now the great honor to announce the 3 winners of the OPCW-The Hague Award for this year. The winners are the Special Risk Brigade of the Argentine Federal Police, the Chemical Weapons Convention Coalition, and the Population Protection Institute of the Czech Republic. Please join me in congratulating them. These year recipients of the OPCW-The Hague Award have been made a tangible and lasting contributions in the areas of assistance, protection, and public outreach that is critical part of the work of the OPCW. The Special Risk Brigade of the Argentinian Federal Police, de la Policía Federal Argentina, has long been working to assist other states to protect their citizens against weapons of mass destruction, including chemical weapons. They have made a noticeable impact in boosting the emergency capabilities of regions, especially in Latin America, but also in the Caribbean and Africa, to prevent and respond to chemical emergencies and incidents. The Brigade has cooperated closely with the OPCW to deliver numerous training programs that have benefited over 800 regional experts. The Chemical Weapons Convention Coalition is an international civil society group with more than 200 members, institutional members, from diverse organizations from around the world that has been promoting the objectives of the convention since 2009. The coalition as tirelessly engaged in public outreach, in addition to conducting wide-reaching educational activities and organizing fora on the obligations and the vital importance of the Convention. The Coalition has successfully worked with the public, as well as disarmament experts and decision makers from across the globe, to raise awareness of the norm against chemical weapons. The Population Protection Institute of the Czech Republic has been delivering for more than 20 years programs for assistance and protection against chemical weapons. They have employed their deep knowledge and expertise in response measures. The Population Protection Institute of the Czech Republic provided training to more than 600 international experts in preparedness for chemical incidents and emergencies. The reach of their activities goes beyond Eastern Europe, and they have extended their training to African experts, including first responders. The recipients will each receive an OPCW-The Hague medallion, an award certificate, and 30,000 euros. For the task of selecting this year's awardees, I wish to thank the members of the award panel: the Mayor, Jan van Zanen of The Hague. Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor, for being with us today. We know that you are very busy, and your presence is very, very appreciated here with us. Ambassador Ziad Al-Attiya, Chairperson of the OPCW Executive Council and Ambassador Permanent Representative of the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Thank you, Ziad, for your generous task to support the organization. Mr. William Garcia, Executive Director of the International Council of Chemical Associations. Thank you very much to Mr. Garcia. Professor Javier Garcia Martinez, President of the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. Thank you very much, Professor, also to you. Each one of us has a role to play in ridding the world of chemical weapons and preventing the lethal harm that can be inflicted using them. No one can tackle the challenges we face alone, even though the greatest burden lies on the organization. I'm confident that this year's recipients will inspire others to continue their efforts towards our shared goal of eradicating these abhorrent weapons forever and ensuring that chemistry is used solely for peaceful purposes. I invite all of you to join me in congratulating the Special Rescue Brigade of the Argentine Federal Police, the Chemical Weapons Convention Coalition, and the Population Protection Institute of the Czech Republic.
Thank you, Director General, for your statement. I now wish to invite the Mayor of The Hague, His Excellency Mr. Jan van Zanen, to make a statement. Your Excellency.
Mr. Chair, Director General, Mr. Arias, Excellencies, distinguished guests, and the winners, of course. This presentation of the OPCW The Hague Award comes in a very special year. The Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons began its work a quarter of a century ago. Here, in the city where as long ago as the Peace Conference of 1899, the very first ban on the use of chemical weapons was adopted. As we all know, they were still used after that, mainly during the First World War. With the entry into force of the Chemical Weapons Convention in 1993 and the founding of the OPCW 4 years later, the international community managed to take an important step forward. Since then, the OPCW staff have succeeded in reducing the threat posed by chemical weapons. The OPCW was therefore awarded the Nobel Peace Prize for its work, and rightly so. I have great respect for the women and men who have dedicated themselves to this work and continue to do so, because it is not without its risks. The Hague is honored by the presence of OPCW. You are one of the reasons why we can describe ourselves as the international city of peace and justice. Wherever possible, the Hague municipality therefore supports the work of OPCW. And the OPCW, the Hague Award, is a part of that. Today, we're honoring people and organizations who, like the OPCW, are working hard to free the world of chemical weapons, or who go into action when a chemical weapon attack occurs or there is an accident involving chemicals. My warmest congratulations to this year's three winners, the Special Risk Brigade of the Argentine Federal Police, the Chemical Weapons Convention Coalition, and the Czech Population Protection Institute. Your work, sadly, is still as relevant as ever. I thank you, therefore, for your dedication. Thank you for making our world a safer place. And it's not just us who are grateful to you. Future generations will be too. Thank you. My respect. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Mayor van Zanen, for your statement. We have now come to the most important part of our gathering today, and that is the presentation of the OPCW The Hague Award to our deserving recipients. I wish to invite the Director General and the Mayor to now present the award medallions and the certificates to the recipients. It gives me pleasure to invite the representative of the Special Risks Brigade, Mr. Christian Rinaldi, to come forward to receive the award on behalf of his organization. It gives me pleasure to invite the representative of the Chemical Weapons Convention Coalition, Mr. Paul Walker, to come forward to receive the award on behalf of his organization. It gives me pleasure to invite the representative of the Population Protection Institute, Lieutenant Colonel Ladislava Navratilova, to come to receive, forward to receive the award on behalf of her organization. Thank you, Director General and Excellency Mayor. I would now like to invite Mr. Rinaldi of the Special Risk Brigade to approach the lectern and deliver the brigade's acceptance speech.
Oh, hello. On behalf of Argentina Federal Police, I would like to say thank you to all the distinguished authorities in this meeting. The Special Risk Brigade belongs to the Federal Superintendence of Firefighters at the Argentina Federal Police. It is a multidisciplinary team conformed by officers from three different branches, CBRN Protection, Chemical, Biological, Radiological, and Nuclear Division. They jointly work with the only purpose of ensuring the safety of the people. Our work with the OPCW formally started in 2012. At that time, we conducted our first pilot advanced training course. We received trainees from South America and Caribbean region. That training course was full of expectation and was the beginning of 10 years of hard working. Not even the pandemic interrupted this work. We adapted our capacities and conducted online trainings. And as a result of this, we had 9 advanced training courses done, 3 decontamination online training courses for the GRULAC, and 1 for African state parties, and 2 modular courses too. Of more than 800 trainees were part of it. Happily, we also had guest instructors from Spain, Poland, United States, Panama, Costa Rica, Uruguay, and Peru. We sincerely appreciate having been nominated for this prestigious award. It is a reflection of more than 10 years of joint work between the OPCW, firefighters, instructors, and trainees, who contributed to achieve the objective that we set a decade ago. It is a recognition of the dedication and effort that characterized the Argentinian Federal Police and its firefighters. It is our desire and commitment to continue actively participating with the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons and its member states, contributing to a world in peace and free of chemical weapons. Congratulations to our colleagues from the Chemical Weapon Convention Coalition and to the Population Protection Institute, the Fire Rescue Service of the Czech Republic. They deserve it too. Thank you, really, thank you very much.
I thank Mr. Rinaldi for his speech. I now invite Mr. Walker of the Chemical Weapons Convention Coalition to approach the lectern and deliver the coalition's acceptance speech.
Director General Arias, Deputy Director General Malono, Mayor van Zanen, Executive Council Chairperson Alitia, CSP Chairperson Madensela, distinguished delegates, CWC Coalition colleagues, and friends. I am highly honored to receive the OPCW-The Hague Award this year on behalf of the Chemical Weapons Convention Coalition. As many of you are well aware, the CWC Coalition was established over a decade ago here in The Hague by a number of non-governmental organizations and representatives to help expand the global reach and recognition of the convention and the OPCW.
Over this decade, we have been able to expand the number of civil society representatives registering for the annual CWC Conference of States Parties from about a dozen individuals, primarily from Western Europe and North America, to over 300 today from every continent in the world. We have only been able to do this with the active support of several government agencies, Global Affairs Canada, the German and Norwegian foreign ministries, the US State Department, the European Union, and the OPCW Technical Secretariat. So I want to express our sincere appreciation to all of these delegations, representatives, and officials. We have also received much support from our many coalition members who have dedicated time, energy, over the past decade to strengthen the global norm against chemical weapons. We were fortunate to have been established by Green Cross International and managed as a project by Green Cross Switzerland for several years, and over the past 4 years by the Arms Control Association. Special thanks also to my coalition colleague, Leanne Quinn, who is here with us today, to the Arms Control Association Executive Director, Daryl Kimball, and to the board and staff of the Arms Control Association for their unwavering support. Let me express my appreciation also to our fellow awardees, the Special Risks Brigade of the Federal Police of Argentina and the Population Protection Institute of the Fire Rescue Service of the Czech Republic for their ongoing good works. The CWC, the OPCW, and all delegations here play a critical role in helping us all build a world free of chemical weapons. But such far-reaching and historic multilateral treaties also require the global village to truly universalize and fully implement their mandates. We therefore will continue to underline the importance of civil society involvement at all levels, local, national, regional, and international, in order to build a much more safe and secure world and to prevent any reemergence of such deadly weapons of mass destruction. We will put the generous prize money to good work strengthening and sustaining the CWC coalition as we approach the fifth CWC review conference next May. And we look forward to working closely, as always, with the OPCW and delegations for many more years to come. Thank you.
I thank Mr. Walker for his acceptance speech. Finally, I'd like to invite Lieutenant Colonel Navratilova of the Population Protection Institute to approach the lectern and deliver the Institute's acceptance speech.
Mr. Chairman, Director General, Mayor of The Hague, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, this is a great honor for me as a commander of Czech OPCW assistance and protection training events and a member of Advisory Board on Education and Outreach to represent Population Protection Institute on this stage in receiving this prestigious OPCW The Hague Award. I also take the opportunity to congratulate the other two organizations for their achievements. Population Protection Institute is a small institution. We have never expected that our effort would receive such high recognition, and we feel deeply grateful, humbled, and honored for this amazing award and the generous financial contribution. Even if we are a small country, the Czech Republic, former Czechoslovakia, have always had rich chemical history. Now I would like to express my thanks to people who nominated us for this award. Firstly, many thanks to Martina Filipiova from the Embassy of the Czech Republic in The Hague, and also thanks to other Czech organizations for their continuous support. My special thanks go to our former students and now African instructors from Kenya, to Steve Ogola, Churchill Aroka Ovala, and Frida Mwaka Chibule, and to Sostene Dain Ginga from Burundi, who nominated us. The Institute is very grateful and receives this nomination with deep respect. Our success wouldn't have been achieved without significant OPCW coordination and support. When we started to teach abroad, assistance and protection branch staff, namely Sean de Kalouve and Dita Ciganikova, showed us how the perfect and fruitful cooperation might look like. Thanks to APB friends for partnership and long-term cooperation. The Population Protection Institute provides education, scientific research, and also rapid intervention during chemical, radiologic, and biological incidents. Our lecturers, scientists, and expert responders educate from personal experience gained during interventions. Release of toxic chemicals, both intentional and accidental, can occur in war zones as well as in peaceful places, during traffic accidents, storage of toxic industrial chemicals, illegal stockpiles, and so on. First responders at the scene must be well prepared, and that is what we teach them. Proper knowledge and preparedness, this is how to win the first battle at the scene where the toxic chemical is released. I would also like to point out that this prestigious award belongs to the entire team of the Institute, which works with great enthusiasm and passion. Since we were nominated by our students, I would like to conclude my speech by quoting a part of closing speech of our this year's participant, Renata Simoes Barros Botona from Brazil. I think that her words really nicely describe the work of Population Protection Institute team. Renata said, "We, participants, started this course with a lot of expectations and a lot of insecurities too. And what did we find in Population Protection Institute? Much more than training and gaining experience. We found here most sincere hospitality, excellent example of organization, professionalism, and contributions from all the experts involved. We also clearly saw in the eyes of instructors their concern for participants to be safe. The lessons we found here were not just about chemical weapons, but also about respect for differences, teamwork, concern for students, and love for profession." Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your attention.
I thank Lieutenant Colonel Navratilova for her acceptance speech. Excellencies, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, this brings to a close the ceremony for the presentation of the 2022 OPCW The Hague Award. I thank you all for your attention and for your participation in this ceremony. I would like to finish once again by congratulating our three well-deserving recipients of this year's awards and recognizing the distances they've all traveled to be here for this special event. I now declare today's ceremony concluded.